Good morning, and welcome to Naturally Kim's Knitting. I'm Kim, and I'm your host, of course, if it's Naturally Kim Knitting. Today is, I was looking at the time and not the date, and that won't get me anywhere. Today is May 4th, 2016, and it's Wednesday. Yay. I want to welcome back all my regular viewers. I love you. You're great. I love to see how many people have been watching each week. So, yay. And any new viewers, I want to welcome you. And please, go to my Ravelry group page, Naturally Kim's Knitting, and introduce yourself. I would love to have drawings, but unless I get 10 people in the group, that's going to be my first drawing for prizes. And it makes it kind of hard if I don't have 10. So please just go there, tell me who you are, where you're from. I'll give you a shout out in the next episode. If you don't want me to, just put that in there. I just really want to know who it is that's watching me each week. So anyways, along with that group page, you can also find me on Ravelry as Napier's Knits. That's where you can find any of the patterns I've designed. I don't have a lot in there yet, but I'm building a little by little. You can find me on Twitter as at KSNapier475, Instagram @knitting_Kim, YouTube Naturally Kim's Knitting, and WordPress, that's just where you can find my show notes. I don't have a link to the video there, but I do have a link where you can find the video. NaturallyKim'sKnitting.wordpress.com. And then on Blogger, that's where you can find the link and show notes and everything. Naturally Kim's Knitting. I'm doing it that way because I just don't have as many people go through WordPress, and I've had a lot of problems getting my video on there sometimes. So if you have problems with it that way, just let me know. I'll be glad to try to figure out how to change it around again. But otherwise, these are the places you can find me. I am hoping to set up a Gmail account before long so that if anybody has any questions or concerns, you can email me and let me know. I would like, if I do that, then I will probably start a Facebook page just for Naturally Kim's Knitting too. So I do want to let you know right up front, I am an affiliate with Knit Picks. So if you like any of the yarns that I show you that's from Knit Picks, please click on my link first and then go to Knit Picks and shop, and that will help me offset prizes, postage, things like that. I'm also an affiliate with Amazon. So the same thing. If you go to my show notes, click a link that takes you to Amazon, then do your shopping, same thing. It will help me out that way. Now, I did set up a Patreon account, and if anybody would like to become a monthly giver, $1, $2, whatever a month, that's going to go to better equipment so that, maybe I'll be able to videotape outside, or maybe I'll be able to get a tripod and try to videotape with my new Kindle, which I'm going to mention in later on. excuse me. And then there's also a PowerPay button for PayPal on my Blogger page. And that's just if you want to give one time. If you like what you see and you'd like to help me out, that will help with equipments. It also helps offset expenses. So I wanted to put that up front because I've had one or two people say, where do we get hold of you? Well, this is where you get hold of me. And as I set up the other places, I will let you know. Okay, I think that's enough business talk right now. Let's just get ready to start our show and talk about what's on the needles. And I'm back. Last week I said something about welcome back, and when my hubby watched it, he goes, but we didn't go anywhere, you did. I said, you're right. So I'm back. Good thing or not. This is a part of the show where I like to talk about what I've been working on the last week. And my daughter's beautiful, beautiful kimono, it's getting closer and closer to being done. last week I had just cast on the sleeves, and I was hoping to totally get them done this week. Well, I am close. You can't even fit the whole sleeve on there real well. I only have to do, I think it's 4 rows of garter stitch, then I'll bind off the sleeve, and you add, that's when you start your edging. So I've got the back blocking right now. I'm gonna put the fronts on this afternoon, and then these will be next, and then I'll be ready to start the edging around the entire sweater. So I'm heading out there in a few weeks, and I really would love to either take this with me or have her have it before I get out there, one or the other. So that, I'm sorry, I should have told you what that is. That's the Reisu Katabira from Knit Kimono 2. Sorry, all my little thingies are coming out. And this is actually the kimono that I'm making. Okay? I'm making it in the Bernat Cottonish. And this is the color. In the Seersucker colorway. I'm using size 9, 5.5 millimeter, 24 inch circulars right now. Then I'll be changing to the US 7s, 4.5 millimeter circulars for the trim. So it's getting closer, which is wonderful. And I check almost every day just to make sure that I'm still on the right needles, even though I don't change them. So, oh well. Where did I put that? Oh, there it is. Even though this isn't on the needle, I'm going to be casting on the other sock today. This is from that Gail's Art sock blank, Lady Sings the Blue. This is the sock I've made, and I just wanted to keep knitting and knitting and knitting until I got it almost done, and I tell you, only had a little bit of yellow left when I cast off the cuff. So this is a long sock, which I love long socks. And if you notice, this is where I was last week. So I knit all of this week. Can you tell? When I love something, I really knit on it. And I love this sock. I love this pattern. This is Cece's French Vanilla Cappuccino sock. And like I said, I made it from Gail's Art sock blank in Lady Sings. No, this isn't Lady Sings the Blue. I'm sorry, I need to change it on my show notes. This is April Showers. Lady Sings the Blue, I've worn, and in fact, I've got them on sock lockers right now drying. I made these on size 1, 2.25 millimeters. The difference between this and Cece's pattern is I do the fish lips heel because I love the way it fits my heel. It doesn't slide off or anything. So I'm going to be getting ready to cast on the next one. You can see I have my needles in and everything this afternoon. Yay! Makes me happy. I should put that in my makes me happy. I've made myself more socks this year than I have any other year in the past. So this is really, you know, I get so happy. I haven't touched the 10-stitch blanket again. I've been too busy trying to get other things to a point where I'll be done with them. So hopefully I'll have fewer things, no promises though, before long. Let's see. I'm also out of, I love to give her books a shout out. This is Cece. I talk about Cece, or right there. That's Cece. I love this lady. Her and her daughter Damaris do a podcast called Geeky Girls Knits. Well, this past year she came out with a book, Coffee with Cece, sorry. And there's 7 sock patterns in it and a shawl pattern. And I, of course, my fallback one is her Vanilla Cappuccino sock, which is the one done in stripes up here. And then I did say last week how I wanted to make this sock. I really wanted to make all of them in the book, but I charted this one and it's just too hard on my fingers, the stitch. I don't know why, but it is. So I am right now making the peppermint mocha sock. And I did it in the closest thing to peppermint I had. It's not really peppermint color, but I love the sock. I just turned the heels. And of course, once again, I did my fish lips heels. But otherwise, this is her pattern. I'm doing this with Knit Pick Stroll Tweed. It's so soft. I love this. And this is going to be for the men's shelter, probably. And last week I had just finished the toes, so I've gotten this much and all the heel on both socks done this week. These are on size 1, 2.25 millimeter. And like I said, it's a Knit Pick Stroll Tweed. I didn't tell you the color. Thirst Heather. Okay? Beautiful. I love heathers. I love the little knobby knobs you get in there, I guess. I don't know what you call them. That's what I call them. And then last, but certainly not least, is my shawl that I'm making in honor to my mother. Just a minute. I think I left the skein around. No, I didn't. Oh, it's hiding. See, when I do my show, I have all these things piled up on the desk in front of me. I'm doing my shawl that's going to be in honor of my mother. And so it's going to be called the Eye of a Jean. And I'm going to, as soon as I get this finished, I'm going to put it up for pattern testing. And then probably on the free pattern testing link on Ravelry, unless anybody out there gets hold of me and tells me that you'd be glad to pattern test a knitted shawl for me. I'm making it out of SWTC's Tofutsi. Three different colorways. I like them together, though. They kind of remind me of flowers, early flowers. And my mom loved flowers. So this is perfect for her for that. I wish I could tell you more about it, but I don't want to spoil any surprises. I'm not sure when I'm going to get this done, but as soon as I do, I will be glad to, as soon as I get it tested and everything, I will be glad to, you got a glimpse. I'll be glad to release it then. I might even make it free for a day or so. Maybe. Okay. That is it for what's on my needle. Sorry, I had to see where I was throwing something. So the next part of my show is going to be finished objects. I'll be right back. Welcome to Finished Objects. This is where I talk about the things that I finished in the last week. As far as knitting goes, there really wasn't that much. I was able to finish two child's chemo caps. Mainly because last week I was just finishing up on this one. I was just to the brim. So I was able to finish that on Wednesday after I finished podcasting. And then I started this one right away. And so I was able to get two done this week. And I tell you, I kind of like this one. I kind of like the straightness of it. But this might be nice on somebody who doesn't like their hats tight. So, two different, but the same. The pattern can be found on Napier's Knits. It's a free download. It's child chemo cap. So if you want to download that pattern, feel free to. Like I said, it's free. I did this because I've had cancer in my family, and I've had a premature children, two little boys that were premature in my family. And I just, my heart goes out to kids and kids with cancer. You know, they're just so innocent, and I like to be able to do whatever I can to help them out. So that's it as far as knitting. Now, I have had fun dyeing yarn. I got some food colorings last week. And I decided, let me have some fun. So I had some fun with color last week. Look at this. I love it. I love this yarn. This is going to make a fun pair of socks or shawl. I haven't decided exactly. Wow, there we go. That's more like the real color. This was just done with regular food coloring, your red, yellow, green, and blue. And I just had fun with this one. And then my husband, he goes to the grocery for me, and he brought me home some neon food coloring too. And I just wanted to see what would happen if I did some purple and some of the blue that they had together. And I like that too. I should say this is on the base from Knit Picks, Felice. And I love it. This is, like I said, food coloring. And it's should be color fast, so yay. And then I told you before that I did some with Kool-Aid, and I had some, I looked through my old Kool-Aid envelopes, and I had a couple black cherry and a couple cherry and a couple grape. And I thought, okay, we're going to try this, see what happens. Oh my goodness. I love this. If this keeps up, I might be opening up a Napier Dyes. That wouldn't be too bad. I would love to do that, because I'm having a blast dyeing yarn. And I would love to be able to share it with anybody. It is so much fun. At least I think so. But then I have so much fun knitting, and I have so much fun, you know, anything like that. So yay. I should have brought it out. My husband, I think I told you at Christmas, he had told me he was going to make me a drum carder and a spinning wheel. Now, the spinning wheel, I don't think he's going to make. I'm going to try to save my money and get myself a spinning wheel. But the drum carder, he's almost finished. Oh, I cannot wait, because I have all this fleece, and I cannot wait to be able to make my own yarn, too. So anyways, that's it for my finished objects this week. But like I said, I had fun finishing these things. Yay. My husband, I have one more skein of yarn to dye. And he goes, I thought, I can't wait to do it. He goes, well, do you need to? He goes, I don't think you need to. I said, but I have one more skein, and it's calling to me. He doesn't have things calling to me like I do sometimes. So he just tells me, I have enough stash, and I say, hey, this is nothing. I said, you should see some of the podcasts I watch. They have them clear up to the ceiling. And he looks at me, I say, hey, they do. Anyways, okay, well, I will be right back with the things that have made me even happier than this this week. Okay, this is the part of the show where I talk about the things that have made me happy this last week, besides dyeing the yarn and knitting the chemo caps and all those things. I had to make sure there wasn't something under there. So I've been a part of a sock yarn club with Highland Handmaids, and this last week was my last shipment. Excuse me, because my husband says I have too much stash. And when it comes to sock yarn, he actually could be right, because I don't see myself using all this sock yarn in a year, plus what I've been dyeing. You never know. It could happen if that was the only thing I knit, but I just don't think so. Don't tell him. I said he might be right. Anyways, so, excuse me. So, Highland Handmade, which is Heather, I don't know how you say your last name, Kinney, K-I-N-N-E, she sent me this beautiful, beautiful, it's called Latent. I love her label. It says, enabling your addiction one fiber at a time. But this is silver maple sock. It's 60% merino, 30% bamboo, and 10% nylon. I mean, this is gorgeous. And it is so soft. And then in addition, she sent me a lot of little stitch markers. I'm so happy with this. So I'll show you. Let me take it out of the bag. I haven't wanted to do that because the stitch markers are so tiny. I'm afraid I'll lose them. But this is the back of her card. Come on, focus. It's thinking about it. There is a link in my show notes. Her podcast is The Fiberista Files, which is so cool. I love her blog too. Oh, I did watch her blog this week. I didn't put that down. And it's Highland Handmaids, like I said. Shophighlandhandmaids.com is her store name. And just because I'm not doing her sock yarn anymore does not mean I will not be ordering from her, because she does such wonderful, wonderful work. She keeps a bullet journal too. She and Cece both do. And I am just starting to do that. And I'm hoping it will help me keep on track of my goals and everything. Oh, I just can't get enough of this yarn. This really did make me happy. This plus the yarns that I hand dyed this week. So cool. I didn't show you, and it's upstairs with my husband. It's upstairs in the bedroom waiting to be mailed to my granddaughter. I reviewed a Jesus Inspires Me coloring book this week, and it was just so cute, and I could see my granddaughter having a blast with that. That's something else she and I have in common. I love to color. She loves to color. So I'm taking a coloring book out and some crayons with me when I go out this next time, and she and I will just sit down together and color, color, color. Now, my whole 30 is still working for me. Other than last Sunday. But my husband and I both agreed I shouldn't kick myself over this. I used to get migraines 3-4 times a week when I used to teach. I love teaching, but I'm not sure if it was the room I was in or what it was, but I'd come home with migraines, and or I'd go home early with migraines, which was just horrid. But somehow or other, in the past year, I've only had a handful of migraines. Well, they've been enough that I've had to get my prescription again, but it's not been enough on my mind that I put my medicine in my purse or in my knitting bag or whatever. And so I went to church on Sunday, and they were doing construction work in there. And I told my husband, I can just tell a migraine's coming on. I said, I don't have my medicine. And he had to do lights that day, and I was in the office, so neither one of us could go home and get it. So I knew that if I don't have my medication, caffeine will work. Well, the only caffeine available at that time on Sunday morning was the cappuccino machine. The caffeine is not a bad thing for me to have, but the sugar in the cappuccino and the dairy in the cappuccino, those are two things that I've eliminated on Whole30. And I have to tell you, even though it got rid of my migraine, well, it made it manageable, so I made it till I got home. Sugar, I've decided, really makes me feel ick. And I just felt, besides the headache, I felt ick for the rest of the day. So I've been on my Whole30, except for that little thing that I couldn't help. It's taught me, though, I take my migraine medicine with me everywhere, because you never know. The minister, our pastor, Pastor Brian, told us, hi, Pastor Brian. I don't know if he's watching this or not. I'll tell him I give him a shout out. He said, I won't promise, but I've been told that the construction will be over next week. So, you know, maybe it won't be an issue, although I don't work in the office the next 3 weeks. So, I'm still going to church, but hopefully it won't be an issue as far as migraines. Because I really do, I've been liking the way I've been feeling. I'm not hurting nearly as much as I did before. Now, the first 30 days, I didn't really notice a difference in the hurting. But my hands have been, I may have had just a couple days where they hurt, and that's usually after gardening. But, you know, my feet, I don't know that they'll ever be pain-free, because, you know, you walk on your feet. And so the arthritis in my feet, I don't think it's ever going to get better. But that's okay. If my hands and my feet don't hurt, it's better. And my thumbs are doing better. But that's partly because of the shop, but it's partly because of the diet. So, you know, as far as the things that they can make me happy, Whole30 is still working. It's still working for me. When I go out to California, I'm going to have to do a modified, because I'm not going to make my daughter make other things for me, and I'm not going to make them eat the foods that I, you know, have to give up the things that I eat or I don't eat. So it'll be modified a little bit, but it'll still be good. Because I always do well out there. I get sunshine and go for walks. I'll just stay away from sugar. But anyways, working in the garden, even though it hurts my hands, it's also been making me happy this week. So as far as what's been making me happy, I've been blessed again this week. Oh, I forgot. Actually, a few other things that made me happy this week. I got a Kindle HD7, I think it's what it's called. Now, this case did not come with it. When I go out to California, I do research on schools for one of my paying jobs, and of course, book reviews. And whereby my daughter wouldn't mind if I used her computer, there are times when both kids are napping and she's using her computer, and I have my own little keyboard then. And I had this for my other Kindle, and this kind, and it works great. The only thing I don't like is this. They usually put a magnet in the handle, and that's not going to stay down because there's no magnet in it. But if that's the biggest thing I have to complain about, life is good. And then I also got a Kindle Fire Stick for TV. We're going to try that and see, because there's some things my husband, I know he would enjoy seeing some things, and it's awful hard to focus your eyes sometimes on one little screen, so we'll be watching it on there. We could do it on our desktop computer, but we have to situate ourselves so that it's not so difficult sometimes, because that's where we have to watch DVDs, is on our computer, and it makes it difficult at times. Anyways, enough of me blathering on. Those are the things that have made me happy. Now I'm going to talk about what I've been reading, listening to, and watching. And it's mainly books and one podcast, and I think that's it. I've been listening to The Hobbit. Anyways, I'll be right back with what I've been reading, listening to. Okay, and I'm back with what I've been reading, watching, and listening to. I need to remember to put this in my show notes. Like I said earlier, I the only podcast I watched this week, I watched Geeky Girls Knits, because I cannot miss that. But then I also watched Highland Handmade. I mean, Fiberista Files. I do enjoy her podcasts. And so I on my new Kindles, I put the little app so I can watch podcasts on there again. Because that's usually first thing in the morning is the time where I turn on my podcast while I'm getting myself ready in the morning. And I can listen and get myself ready at the same time. So those are two things that have that I've been watching this week. As far as reading, I have reviewed a couple books this week. One is called Courageous Gentleness. It is really good. It's nonfiction, of course, and it's about your Christian walk, about how there is no reason why we cannot be gentle in our approach to others about our faith. Our actions sometimes, I'm sorry, I'm bouncing myself as I talk. It must be annoying. I hope you weren't getting seasick. But it's about how your actions almost, define you as a Christian as much as the words come out of your mouth. And any of my kids that I used to teach in 5th and 6th grade know that I preach this a lot. I used to have boys that would be on soccer teams. And they were good. Yes, they were good. But they would come in to class and they would talk about how they were going to stomp all over these guys. And I would stop them because it was a Christian school. And on their shirt, it would have the name, Temple Christian School. And I would tell them, are you showing that you're Christians other than in your names? Because we didn't play all Christian schools. I said, what if some of these kids have never, given their lives to Jesus yet? You're not showing them how to be a Christian. Well, this book kind of backs that all up. And I loved it. And I did put the review for that on my review page. And then there's a link to it on my show notes. And then whenever I read, whenever I read a nonfiction book like that, that's, you know, not dry, but, you know, it's nonfiction. I like to read something light. And this came from the Christian Book Club Network. And it's Anything for a Story, with story crossed out, mystery. And it's the first book in A Nosy Neighbor Mystery by Cynthia Hickey. It's so cute. It is so cute. Let me read the back to you, because I don't remember word for word what I put in my review. But it said, Stormy Nelson, best-selling romance author, moved into her huge Victorian house in the private community of Oak Meadows Estate to live a solitary life. When her agent tells her that her characters are being too cardboard and that she needs to get out and mingle with people, Stormy comes up with the idea of a neighborhood watch program. The only problem is, she's the only member. On her first night of patrol, she stumbles over a dead body, meets a hunky detective who happens to be her neighbor and is clearly frustrated with her and becoming the owner of a giant dog. Her mother, sister, niece, and nephew arrive to shake up Stormy's peaceful life. As she is immersed ever deeper in the mystery surrounding a neighbor's murder, Stormy decides to change her writing tactics and write a romantic mystery based on her experiences. Can she find the killer before she becomes the next victim? It's so cute. I know that anybody who likes light mysteries like this is going to love this book. It is good. And then I'm also reading right now, I don't have it with me right now, but it's a Kindle book called The Remaining, and I'm not showing it right now because I'll do that when I finish it, after I review it and everything. It's an end of times book, but it doesn't start with the end of times. It starts with a woman's visions of what's going to happen, and it pulls you in from that. And it is really, really good. I wish I had more time, and I wish I were a faster reader, because I would have finished this book by now. My eyes get tired sometimes from reading, but I am loving it, and I will probably have it done by next week, and I'll review it then. As far as that, let's see, I've been watching Downton Abbey Season 3, so I've been loving that. I've been watching that up with Amazon Prime. And like I said, Geeky Girls Knits and Highland Handmade, or Fiberista File, sorry. That's what I've been watching this week. This isn't going to be a super long podcast this week. Kind of nice about that. Anyways, I will be back with any announcements or any little notes to let you share with you. Okay? I'm back. As far as announcements, I just really only have the, looking for pattern testers. If you're interested, please leave PM me on Ravelry, or you could leave a comment on Blogger or WordPress for me. Any of those, I would be glad to get back with you. Just when you do that, let me know about how long you've been knitting and what kind of things you like to knit. Okay, because I'm planning on, after I get this super secret shawl done for my mother, I'm going to be working on socks and cowls and things like that. So let me know. Okay, otherwise, you can find me on Ravelry as Napier's Knits, and the show's group is Naturally Kim's Knitting, both those on Ravelry. Twitter at KSNapier475, Instagram, knittin_Kim, that's KNITTIN_Kim, YouTube, Naturally Kim's Knitting, WordPress, all one word, naturallykimsknitting.wordpress.com. Now, like I said, that's only show notes. I'm not going to have a link to the show there, per se. And Blogger, Naturally Kim's Knitting. You can also find me on Patreon if you want to. If you would like to support me. And there's also a PayPal button on my Blogger page. Anybody who would like to support me one time. Patreon is more like a monthly giving thing. for each level of giving in Patreon, there's different things that you will get in return. Otherwise, it's been a good week for me. I hope you've had a good week. Love to everybody. Take care. Big hugs and happy, happy knitting.